Tango. Tango has captured the imagination of the world yet one more time. Tango travels the world. It's in every major city on every continent. And if you are a milonguero, which is to say someone who has devoted himself or herself to the dancing of Argentine tango, of whatever nationality, you can enter into this culture, no matter where you are, simply by understanding how to speak the silent language of tango. A milonga, a gathering where we come together to dance the tango. The customs of tango allow us to enter into a kind of nighttime haven where we embrace one another in ways that perhaps we wouldn't under less respectful circumstances. We seek to enter a pact with our dance partner in what many people have called a 3-minute love affair. But this love affair depends a lot less on whom you are with and a great deal more on the shared experience of the dance. Together, we love tango. Listen. Watch.
Ya soy como un pintor, ahora una corrida, una vuelta, una sentada, así se baila el tango, un tango de mi flor. Así se baila el tango, sintiendo en la cara la sangre que sube a cada compás, mientras el brazo como una serpiente se enrosca en el estalle que se va a quebrar. Así se baila el tango, mezclando el aliento, cerrando los ojos para oír mejor, como los violines lo dicen al fuelle, porque desde esa noche Malena no canto. Se baila el tango mientras dibujo el ocho para estos filigranas. Ya soy como un pintor, ahora una corrida, una vuelta, una sentada. Así se baila el tango, un tango de mi flor.
Tango music is rich and varied. There are three basic categories of music to which we dance. One is a tango like we just saw. There are also tango waltzes, and there is the milonga, which is a separate dance form and music form. And we'll get to that in a minute. Now, when we dance at a milonga like this, we usually dance to recorded music. And so there will be a set of tangos, usually played by the same orchestra, followed by another set by another orchestra, another set by another orchestra, and so on and on through the evening. And couples develop preferences for certain orchestras, and sometimes a couple will wait until the set by their particular orchestra comes before they begin to dance. It's very interesting. So now we will look at another set, another tango rather. Our dancers will dance a tango by the great orchestra of Riccardo Tanturi. Thank you.
un cacho en cada salón de mi ciudad. De la unión al agujero, con ella te ves soñando a compás. Silencioso va la voz y dejas que hable por vos la milonga en su floreo. Viejas quejas de pasión, renovando pareja con este sol. Mi abuelo con los pingos y encadenado a tus tangos, hoy vivo cautivo del ritmo blusón. Emoción hay una sola y es el llanto de los cuellos haciendo acordes de arona. Ay, no, no de los domingos, remanso del corazón.
Usually gathered into sets of three or four tangos each, called tandas. The music keeps the couples dancing until we come to what we just heard, the cortina, which is a short break between sets. Now, the cortina is short, but it's very important because it's at this moment that the search for the next partner begins. Now, while in this country, I might approach a beautiful woman and say, "Oh, Beatrice, would you dance the tango with me, please? Later." In Argentina, the couples prefer a custom which is called el cabeceo. Now, el cabeceo is an invitation to the dance which can be negotiated from all the way across the dance floor, if necessary. The music begins. And he begins his search. He's looking for just that woman who we would love to dance to this tanda with, of tangos. And she's searching also. She danced with this fellow maybe last week, or a girlfriend of hers said, "Oh, you should dance with him. He's really good." So their eyes circle and circle, and finally when their eyes meet, they pause, and he nods his head. El cabeceo. Now she, he cuts a fine figure. Intelligent as well. He's a fine dancer, everyone knows that. So she nods her head in consent. So now, let's watch as our dancers dance to a set of tango waltzes by Alfredo de Angelis.
No vuelvas, María, que nada ha quedado de aquella alegría que honrado te di. María. El eco cansado de un balbalarín. María, no vuelvas, María, trayéndome ingrata la mancha escarlata de tu frenesí.
te quiero. María, María, de mi corazón.
Listen, it's a fact. Tango is not an easy dance to learn. It requires a certain attention, I guess you'd say. But the challenge of melding together and twisting and dancing and walking across this floor with this partner to this music, that intrigues us. And the challenge of doing it with someone who might be a complete stranger, that intrigues us even more. We wait for those moments when the body and the state of mind and the soul all come together with this music. Those are blissful moments, euphoric ones, timeless sometimes. But really, it's just a gift.
Ingratitud y dolor, pobre flor, hoy es sepulcro y paz de mis ansias de pasión. ¿Por qué no vuelve más lo que amé con frenesí? Ay, que se han hecho los besos que con embeleso me diste a mí.
Todo lo cubrió el olvido con su manto triste para no volver, siendo mi ilusión primera solitaria tumba de mi último amor.
Juramento vano de una boca ardiente con ponzoña y maldición,
pero el recuerdo grabado
como una mortaja eterna sobre el alma mía triste la cubrió. Y por eso entre tinieblas voy meditabundo vagando al azar,
con tu nombre escrito con una sentencia de no poder olvidar
el corazón que te amó.
Cubrí el olvido con su manto triste para no volver, siendo mi ilusión primera solitaria tumba de mi último amor.
Juramento vano de una boca ardiente con ponzoña y maldición,
pero el recuerdo grabado
como una mortaja eterna sobre el alma mía triste la cubrió. Y por eso entre tinieblas voy meditabundo vagando al azar,
con tu nombre escrito con una sentencia de no poder olvidar
el corazón que te amó.
If there's a hierarchy in tango, it has to do with your skill. I mean, how good a dancer are you really? Now, what you do for a living doesn't matter. The prowess that you exhibit at the office every day doesn't matter. Good looks. Now, that might get you a dance once. But it's your skill and a welcoming attitude that keep you dancing all evening long. So now, we've seen a tanda of tangos. We've looked at a tanda of tango waltzes, and now it's time for milonga. It's true that milonga is the gathering, a milonga is the gathering where we come together to dance the tango. But milonga is a dance form and a music form in its own right. So now let's consider one of the more cheerful aspects of Argentine tango as our dancers dance to a pair of milongas by the great orchestra of Francisco Canaro.
Sacale viruta al piso hasta romper los zapatos. Sacale el hilo a esa chaucha, si es que tenés buenas uñas. Thank you.
The thing that fascinates me about this social dance that we've been watching this afternoon is that, believe it or not, every step we've seen has been extemporized spontaneously. Of course, out of a body of Argentine tango vocabulary that's a couple of hundred years old. Now, in the tango, the man leads and the woman follows. But, of course, believe me, both roles are equally important. And I think that the major distinction between the Argentine tango and the American or international tangos that maybe you've seen on television or in those ballroom dance contests, the major distinction is Argentine tango's highly improvisational nature. I mean, rather than dancing to fixed patterns, we dance the tango one step at a time. Really, tango is just a walk. We can walk forward. We can walk to the side. We can walk to the other side. And making sure that there's no one there, we can take a step to the rear. We can go to the cruzada, the cross. And from the cruzada, we can do forward ochos, figure eights, so named for the lovely way that my partner's hips sway as she dances them. And back ochos. We can do the giro, the turn, which can end in the parada, the stop. And it's here that she can do all sorts of decorations and ornaments that are so beautiful. Ooh. But be careful, this could lead to a step which is a little risky. It's called the gancho, the hook. I can gancho her also. Or we can go to the barrida, the sweep. I sweep her, she sweeps me. El sandwichito, the little sandwich. So many possibilities in tango. So many. So, from the vast sea of Argentine music, we select tangos that set the mood of an evening with these tangos that we select. And the music brings the partners, the dancers, to a state of focused meditation, both creatively and emotionally, in which the dance itself becomes a language of its own. The instruments of the orchestra begin to play. They play to our feet. They play to our hearts. They play to our souls, and they take us to oblivion. Now, this tango, it's a very old one. It's a very famous one. And it's almost always played at the end of a milonga, and it's called La Comparsita. In 1913, the Countess Melanie de Portal was a French woman living in Paris. She was an elderly woman, a very wealthy woman, an aristocrat, a blue blood, a true member of the Ancien Régime. And several of her younger relatives came to her apartment one day to show her this dance craze that was sweeping Paris, the tango. And they did a couple of tangos. And when the music stopped, they stopped. And they looked for a reaction from the Countess. They were a little worried that she might be a bit put off by this rather suggestive dance. And they waited. And they waited. And then finally she pulled a little silk handkerchief from her sleeve. And she daubed herself with it a little bit, waved it in front of her lips, and said to her young niece, "Oh, but dearest, did they have to dance it standing up?"
Thank you.
Argentine tango has been described in many ways, and not one of those descriptions has been half-hearted or mild. An Argentine writer named Leopoldo Lugones once referred to it as the reptile from the brothel. The Argentine poet Horacio Ferrer wrote, "The tango itself is entirely poetic. It's the world of the night. It's the bohemian world where money has little importance, and to be sure, love has a great deal of importance. Triumphant love or destroyed love." The extraordinary dancer Juan Carlos Copes wrote that the music arouses and torments. And the other great dancer, Carlos Gavito, how could I forget? Carlos Gavito said, "When you dance tango, you are not dancing a step. You are dancing an emotion." The writer Jorge Luis Borges, who had a kind of a love-hate relationship with the tango, took many lyricists to task when he accused them of indulging in loud self-pity while shamelessly rejoicing in the misfortunes of others. And most famously, the Argentine lyricist Enrique Santos Discépolo said that tango es un pensamiento triste que se baila. Tango is a sad thought danced.
Thank you. dichosos aquellos que lloran un día y olvidan después. Yo no sé llorar, aguanto el sufrir. Y aunque esto es horrible, rastrero y cobarde, no sé maldecir.
Perhaps the most famous writer in worldwide in all of Argentinian history was Jorge Luis Borges. He was a librarian by profession, and he liked a certain kind of tango. But his was the tango of the pampas, the open plains and the wild rambling cowboys, the gauchos. He liked knife fights and intrigue, that sort of thing, the 19th century. He didn't care much for the urban angst of the tango that came along during and after World War I, such things as love's betrayal and abandonment and drink. He wrote an essay about this. When they started doing this tango, they were very successful. And then people started writing tangos especially for these kinds of singers. Tangos that followed the model that everyone now knows, the one in which he abandons some woman, and, for example, and he also says that he doesn't care about anything anymore. Now, I prefer a tango that is more godfather, more gangster. And this new tango is the complete opposite of that. It's just a complaint. And in an atmosphere of true bad guys, no man would complain about some woman he's left. I've got a couple of nephews that are crazy about it, true archaeologists of the new recordings. They listen to them with a kind of religious emotion. And my sister, too, she likes them a great deal. And when she listens to these records, she goes into herself and says, oh, the voices. The voices. Me, never. Because in the end, this music has done nothing but bring the Argentine people to sadness. When tango first came, it was always very happy, brave, moving. And then came along this wretched, crooked tango with a great big sob at the end. Now, this kind of controversy continues to this day. Not everyone agreed with Borges then, and it would be the same now. describing the early years of the 20th century, excuse me. The Uruguayan writer Eduardo Galeano writes that tango, wistful offspring of the gay milonga, had been born in the corrals at the city's edge and in tenement courtyards. It came from gaucho tunes from the interior and from the sea, the chanties of sailors. It came from the slaves of Africa and the gypsies of Andalusia. Spain contributed its guitar, Germany its bandoneon, Italy its mandolin. The driver of the horse-drawn streetcar contributed his trumpet, the immigrant worker his harmonica, companion of lonely moments. With hesitant step, tango spanned barracks and dives, the midways of traveling circuses and the patios of slum brothels. Organ grinders paraded it through shore streets on the outskirts of Buenos Aires and Montevideo, heading downtown, and ships took it away where it drove Paris wild.